The station covering all of the DMV. This is DC News.
Anything
now.
Could have happened to the kids or even to the singles that in the singles center.
Now at 10 on DC News Now, threat averted. Drugs, a gun, and a dramatic chase. Body cam video we have tonight show you how it all ends.
And an arrest made in a fatal crash in Rock Creek Parkway. What we're learning about the driver's history tonight.
Hi, everyone. It's really good to see you on this Monday evening. We are talking about clear skies and high pressure taking over the DMV. Only concern going into your holiday weekend. We are tracking some raindrops. We'll look at that coming up.
Overall, the city probably has 7% committed affordable housing overall.
And how to fix the fact that people are getting priced out of one Northern Virginia city tonight? We'll tell you the latest. And good Monday evening. Thank you so much for joining us for DC News Now at 10 on DCW 50. I'm Tasmeen Mahfouz.
Hi, everybody. I'm Chris Flanagan. Our top story tonight, a gun, bag of drugs, and a police chase, all near an elementary school in Seat Pleasant in Prince George's County, Maryland.
And police body cam video that we have tonight of how it all went down. It happened near Seat Pleasant Elementary School on G Street, right near Addison Road.
Yeah, DC News Now, Yamari Sisse has our story.
Police say while 22-year-old Kimani Rhodes was running, he dropped a bag full of drugs and then threw his gun on top of the Seat Pleasant Activity Center. All of this taking place just steps away from an elementary school where students were about to be dismissed. Body cam video from May 11th shows 22-year-old Kimani Rhodes running from a Seat Pleasant police officer after being approached for standing at a nearby playground with a gun. Police say Rhodes dropped the bag while running, then threw a handgun on top of the roof of the Seat Pleasant Activity Center.
We've restructured our crime reduction model, which of course assigns a police officer to the elementary school. And in fact, that officer is the one who identified that suspicious person and placed him under arrest.
Stay down.
Police were able to finally catch Rhodes and arrest him. The incident took place just a few feet away from Seat Pleasant Elementary School, just before students were about to be dismissed. Later, police say they found 300 grams of marijuana and 9 grams of cocaine individually bagged inside the book bag Rhodes dropped. Employees like Annie Allen, who've worked at the Seat Pleasant Activity Center for years, tell me the entire situation is alarming.
I feel very unsafe about that. You know, I don't think it should have happened because, first of all, we have young kids around here and there's a school there, and anything could have happened to the kids or even to the singles that in the singles center. So I'm very concerned about that.
Rhodes is facing several gun and drug-related charges, and he is being held without bond. He's scheduled for a hearing in June. For now, reporting in Seat Pleasant, Maryland, I'm Yamar Sisse, DC News Now.
And a developing story tonight out of Northeast D.C. where a student was shot outside of KIPP D.C. College Prep School. And take a look at this car on your screen. That's a picture we just got in from police. And this is a car that they're looking for. Whoever was in it, police say tonight, is the suspect. Now, the student shot is stable and expected to be released from the hospital tonight. The high school right near Gallaudet University went into a lockdown around 1:40 this afternoon after the student was found outside. MPD secured the school over the next hour before students could leave during a controlled dismissal. Now, in an email tonight to families, school says they are closing tomorrow and will reopen Wednesday. Mental health practitioner and other mental health services will be on site Wednesday, along with more police presence. And in that same email, school administrators said this, quote, "We are outraged and concerned by the uptick in violence in our community. The safety of our students and staff is our top priority. We will continue to work with MPD and city leaders to ensure that students and staff are safe at school." Now, the school also encouraged parents to monitor the well-being and emotional health of their children. They urge families to reach out to the school or MPD if they have any safety concerns. Again, this is still a developing story. We'll keep you updated both here on air and online on DCNewsNow.com.
Every day we work hard to protect our students because if we can't keep them safe, then we're not providing an adequate learning environment for them.
It has now been nearly 1 year since the deadly shooting at Robb Elementary School in Uvalde, Texas. What changes have been made since then, both in Uvalde and the DMV and across the country? We look at that tonight, all new at 10:30. And developing right now, a woman is facing murder charges 2 months after a deadly crash on Rock Creek Parkway.
Yeah, police arrested 43-year-old Nikita Marie Walker. They say she was behind the wheel of an SUV that hit a small Honda, killing all three people inside. DC News Now's Mariel Carbone is live on P Street tonight. That's right near where the crash happened.
And Mariel, you spoke tonight to a family member of one of the victims who says he's grateful someone is finally being held accountable.
Yeah, that's what he said. And he also says that this is the first step towards getting justice. But any relief tonight, it's not that much because the loss is still there. And Chris and Thasmeen, all of this is just that much more frustrating for the family, knowing that Walker has a history of reckless driving and DUIs.
You've destroyed three families. You've taken away three hopes.
That's the message Mohamed Fofana has for Nikita Marie Walker, the woman U.S. Park Police arrested Monday and identified as the driver in this fatal crash on Rock Creek Parkway back in March. It killed three people, including Mohamed Kamara, Fofana's brother-in-law.
For a guy who's so soft and quiet and takes his time to do everything, It's unfortunate he died so soon.
Kamara, an immigrant from Sierra Leone, was driving for Lyft when Walker allegedly hit his car, killing him and both his passengers. Police say they were trying to stop the 43-year-old for a speeding violation when she sped off and crashed.
So it's not like some young kid who doesn't know better, just joyriding and stuff like that. This is someone who's been doing this for a while.
According to court records, Walker has a history of reckless driving. She was charged and convicted three times for driving drunk, including in 2015, 2018, and 2020. Plus, the car Walker was driving has more than $17,000 of unpaid traffic fines. She's now charged with second-degree murder.
It's a failure in the system. License should be revoked.
Fofana hopes Walker's arrest can lead to justice for his family. As for what that looks like,
what will give us a little more comfort is knowing that the justice system can put things in place to make sure this doesn't happen to another family.
And at the time of the March crash, Walker was still on probation from her 2020 DUI. We also know that back in 2019, she was ordered to have a breathalyzer attached to the ignition of her car or any cars that she was driving. Chris and Thasmeen, we are expecting her to be arraigned in court tomorrow morning. Reporting live in Northwest D.C. tonight, I'm Mariel Carbone, D.C. News Now.
Mariel, thank you. As Mariel mentioned, both passengers in Kamara's car were killed that night. They're identified as 23-year-old Jonathan Mendez and 22-year-old Alvin Torres Velasquez.
All right, let's get a check on the forecast with our chief meteorologist, Janessa Webb.
Janessa, if you like today, you'll love the rest of the week.
The rest of the week. Yeah. It's just not tomorrow. It's
right.
For the next 5 days,
like
very
that.
Dry, inactive weather pattern. And so it's pretty nice across the DMV. And really, if you're going up and down the East Coast, it's a very dry condition. So, folks, if you're doing some traveling for this holiday weekend, zero concern weather-wise. Across most of even the Ohio Valley, Upper Tennessee Valley to the deep south, we just have high pressure that's pretty much in control. It's a dome of high pressure, and so it's going to be hard for this thing to really be budged out of our region. Currently, our temps, they're very mild at the 10 o'clock hour at 70 degrees. Here's the contrast, though. South of 66, upper to middle 50s in most spots. But then look at kind of a microclimate situation that's kind of unfolding here. Hagerstown, 70, and then you travel out towards Martinsburg, upper 50s. And so there is that contrast. There's a limited wind flow out there as well. So satellite composite radar, a few clouds that are tracking in from the south, really uneventful. And so for your evening planner into tomorrow morning, you're going to see overnight lows across the district in the middle to upper 50s under partly cloudy skies. Excuse me. We do have one concern, though, as we go into your holiday weekend, tracking a few raindrops. We'll look at that coming up.